Azure Sentinel leveraged machine learning technology fusion to automatically detect multi-stage attacks by identifying combinations of anomalous behaviors and the suspicious activities that are observed at various stages of the kill chain. To help you discover threats and anomalous behaviors that are more tailored to your environment, Fusion can now leverage a set of scheduled analytics rules for detecting multi-stage attacks. In this video, I'd like to walk you through how to create and enable the scheduled analytics rules in Azure Sentinel and how to investigate incidents created by Fusion. First, let's see how to create and enable scheduled analytics rules. Currently, I'm in the Azure Sentinel workspace. To create a scheduled rule, you will first navigate to the Analytics blade. In this view, you can see active rules and rule templates. Let's click rule templates to see what scheduled rule templates do we have and their status. You can search for the rule templates that are supported by Fusion. Now let's try multiple password reset. Here you can see the status shows that this rule is in use. Now let's hop back to the active rule section to review the schedule rule that is already active. Here is the multiple password reset by user. You can see it's enabled. Now let's click edit to see the details of the settings. In the analytics rule details, you can see name of the rule. Renaming the templates will not impact Fusion detections. Fusion ML algorithm does fuzzy matching for the KQL queries provided in the templates, so as long as you are not making major edits to the KQL query, Fusion can support the rule that you have enabled. Tactics information in the schedule rule is also important for the Fusion detection. This is because the Fusion ML algorithm takes the kill chain information into consideration. Missing tactics information in the incoming alerts may have impact on Fusion detections. In addition, the tactics you include in the analytics rules will show up in the resulting incidents. This could be a valuable piece of information for your investigation. Now let's move on to set rule logic. For here, please make sure to include entity mapping information. Fusion correlates alerts based on entities such as user account or IP address. The ML algorithm cannot perform alert matching without the entity information, so it is important that you review and configure this section. Next, the configuration for the incident settings and alert grouping here won't impact Fusion detections. Our Fusion algorithm will take all alerts generated from the supported schedule rule into consideration, apply ML analysis, and only generate high fidelity incident. There are a couple more settings to go through. Now you can see the schedule rule is enabled and it is ready to be leveraged by our Fusion detections. Let's move on to take a look at the incidents generated by Fusion. To review incidents created by Fusion, navigate to the incident blade. Here you can see all the incidents. Here's an example of a Fusion incident leveraging the schedule rule we configured earlier. You can click on the incident and view the full incident details. In this case, you can see a high severity Fusion incident composed of two alerts, impossible travel to atypical locations, and multiple password reset by user. The multiple password reset by user was generated from the schedule rule we configured earlier. Looking at the incident description, you can see both anomalous signals are related to the user JFL. You can also see the details about the suspicious logging IP and the location here. For this scenario, Fusion generated a high fidelity incident from these two alerts to show a possible attempt by attacker to perform multiple password resets for malicious purpose after compromising the user account noted in the Fusion incident description. This is a potential multi-stage attack indicating two kill chain stages, credential access after initial access. On the right side, you can find the timeline for the two underlying alerts as well as the kill chain information. In this case, the timeline indicated that the multiple password reset by user was detected about 6 hours after the detection of impossible travel to atypical locations. You can also view alert details, bookmarks, entities, and add comments during your investigation. One thing I want to highlight here is that Fusion may generate incident based on a new alert and an alert that has been included in a previous incident. For example, you might have seen a previous incident triggered on the same impossible travel to atypical locations alert and have investigated this alert already. However, if it shows up in a Fusion incident with a new alert, in this case, multiple password reset by user, it means that Fusion has identified a net new attack scenario and we recommend you to take actions to investigate. If you would like to look for the previous incidents that included the same alert, you can use the query we provided in the incident description here to do a quick search. In order to do the quick search, you will need the incident ID as well as the alert ID here. This is an example of the search query. You can set the time range, add alert ID and incident ID, and then click Run. In the results, you can get the list of incidents triggered on the same alert for reference. Now let's go back to the incident. In addition to what you can see here, you can also investigate the incident using the investigation graph. The investigation graph shows the relationships between the entities graphically. Notes can be expanded to review more context. You can also click on the sidebar to review more information, including timeline, entities, etc. That's how you can configure a schedule rule for Fusion detection and how you investigate a Fusion incident in Azure Sentinel. Hope you find this video helpful. To learn more about Fusion, visit aka.ms/sentinel-fusion. You can find more information about the schedule analytics rules supported by Fusion and the list of Fusion detection scenarios on the page.